Hi guys, Chris here back with the Teclast F7 Plus. This video I'm going to show you how to improve the thermals. So it's going to be my copper heatsink mod. We're going to add a heatsink on there, a thermal pad. It'll improve the thermals and it'll allow you to increase the power limit if you wanted to boost the performance, mostly the graphics performance. So you don't have to do this mod whatsoever if you don't need to, okay? The thermals are perfectly fine as they are out of the box. So to open it up, before we get started, you need to remove the two rear rubber feet because we actually have two screws hidden underneath this. So once you remove all the rear screws, including the ones for the SSD hatch, then you can lift the whole back off. So the easy method of this mod would be to just simply place a 2mm thick thermal pad, a nice large one, right here, over the top of the chipset, and just leave it at that. That will transfer, I feel, enough heat to the rear case to act as just a larger heatsink, enough to increase that power limit to 9 or 10 watts. Now, because we are going to be touching around the circuit board, it would be wise to unplug the battery now, which I've done right here, as you can see. So just lift up that tape and then unplug that connector there. Now, you will lose any settings in your BIOS. Now, lifting up that heatsink, you can see there is the Gemini Lake, and all it had on top of it was just a very thin thermal pad, which is 0.5mm thick. So I just cleaned up the top of the CPU die there, as you can see, and I removed the thermal pad. That's the stock one that was on top of the heatsink that's just off camera at the moment. So you can use a 15x15, 1mm thick copper shim, one that I've got right here, or a 21. This is even larger. Now, yes, you can see all those resistors around there that are very close to that, that could cause problems. It could touch, it could short. But in my experience, I've been doing this for years, that has never actually happened to me, because when you put the thermal paste on there and then you screw back the heatsink, it's not going to move around. It'll be fine there. If you are worried about that, then go with something that fits the die size precisely. So go for something like 10x10mm, 1mm thick shim. Now I've placed a thin layer of thermal paste on top of the die there, as you can see. I just used some Noctua. This is NTH1. You don't have to use a super high quality one because this is not a 65 watt desktop CPU in here. This is a 6 watt CPU, and we're going to only increase it probably to about 10 watts, and it will use 15 watts max. So I have spread it out, as you can see, with a plastic bag. So I just use my finger and a plastic bag here, just like the baggy method, I think people call it, just to put a real nice thin layer on there. You do whatever method you want there, but this is what works for me. Now I'm going to place a copper shim on the top. I've actually decided to go with a larger size that I've used before in the past with good results. So this one is 20mm by 20mm, 1mm thick. Okay, so I just pressed it down. That is more or less centered there. And now right in the middle of it, I'm going to place just a very small amount, again, of that thermal paste that I've used. And I have on the back of the copper heatsink, this is the stock one, of course, just cut out a wider gap here. Now, originally I made it for, of course, the 15mm, and then I had to increase that for the 20mm, that size there. So it's just going to have flush contact then with the factory copper heatsink. Yes, it looks a little bit crude here, but I mean, this doesn't really matter. And I've just spread out all over the top of the heatsink that I placed there, that thermal paste, just evenly all over the top. You can just put a big blob on the top if you want, or do it however method you want. And now to put the heatsink back on, make sure you put it on the correct way. And now I'm going to place a 2mm thick thermal pad on the top here. This is going to be transferring heat over to the rear, the bottom of the case, so the laptop will get a little bit hotter. About there should be fine. Remember to plug that battery back in if you did unplug it. Place the tape, of course, back on top of the plug too. That's just to keep it in place, not that it would fall out. And now we need to put the lid back on. So So it's going to be a little bit harder to place on, but you just need to apply a little bit of pressure when you screw it back on. The more pressure, the better on top of our copper heatsink there. All right, I did find this. There's like a little tiny sponge here. This is to apply pressure onto where the copper heatsink is. Remove this. You're going to have to remove that because now we've got a thermal pad in its place. And here what we want to do is go along and just where it says power limit 1 enabled, just disable that. That's disabling your power limit, so it'll use all the power it wants, but we still need to run the software unlock method if you want the best gaming performance. Here you see I have the power limit disabled, so you go out of the BIOS here, you got to save it, of course, exit, boot back into Windows. Okay, so an impressive result here. I've got 83 frames per second and a very easy Half-Life Lost Coast video stress test. You can get this off Steam, by the way, for free to try and compare the results here. So max temperatures, about 58, 60 degrees is what it's going to reach at the moment. The longer you play, the hotter it's going to get. But the same exact test, when I did it with a 10 watt power limit with no copper heatsink mod, it reached 93 degrees. So you can see there that the difference is absolutely massive when you do these mods and you unlock the power limit, you can almost double the frame rate. Well, not quite double because before I got about 58 frames per second and now it is about 83, almost 84. And now looking at the difference it's made with a game, this is Counter-Strike Global Offensive that when I tested this in my review was getting about 30 frames per second and now we're up about, and dead already, up about 20 frames per second. Temperatures are reaching, however, 70 degrees. So it's still getting a little warm, but this is so much cooler than having this stock. If this was stock, it would be running into thermal throttling, 99 degrees now without the copper heatsink mod and no power limit, of course. So thank you so much for watching this copper heatsink mod on the Teclast F7 Plus. Bye for now.